It's Linda Cromer. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado, and I have finally, I think, mastered getting two videos going at once and not having one overpower the other or shadowing the other or whatever, and getting a video that actually lets it look like I'm talking to both of you at the same time. I'm looking in the same place, so both videos are going at once, one in Facebook and one in Periscope. That just helps me use my time more wisely. But both of you, I'm talking to you on the same subject. Light is always more powerful than dark. Now, why am I talking about that when it has to do with anything with business? Because I usually relate it to business. And I will get to that. But think about that for a minute. Do an experiment. Use a flashlight. Make a room really, really dark. And then walk into the room if you have a high-powered flashlight. What happens to the room? It's no longer dark, right? Now, on the other hand, if there's darkness, see if you can close off the room enough to make the flashlight actually extinguish its light. You can't do it, right? The only way that you can extinguish the light is if you purposely turn the flashlight off. And that is the only time that the light actually will trump up the light. Is the light will not actually be extinguished unless there's a action upon it that makes that happen. And that is also true when it comes to your own belief system. Your light, your belief, your essence is not going to be extinguished unless you choose to let it be. You're not going to allow darkness or doubt or anything that is sinister penetrate you unless you choose that for yourself. So think about that for a minute. I know myself. I've worked very, very hard at building myself and building my belief. And so because I've done that, I don't allow darkness to overcome me. Now, I might have a moment once in a while of doubt or fear, but I don't let it become overpowering to the point where it takes over my life. And I think that's really, really important when it comes to truly building what you want to build. If you want your business to grow, you have to grow the light, your belief, your essence, all the time. Now, sometimes people call that personal development. Sometimes people just call that a belief system. You could call it whatever you want. But I choose to call it your light. Do you let your light shine to others? Because if your belief and your power grows, guess what that attracts? It attracts people that feel like they want that. They want to be around that. On the other hand, if you let yourself get negative, doubtful, fearful, you don't attract anything. The light goes away, and nobody wants to be around that. So think about that for a minute in your own business. Are you working on building your light? Are you working on becoming more? Are you working on becoming what is attractive? Because people are not attractive to people that are doubtful or fearful. So you have to be the one that is building yourself to the point where you become that light that people are attracted to. Just as I have a light shining right on my face, just so that I won't look dark in this picture, that's important for you to be doing in your business. Light makes people excited. Excitement is created by being in a feeling of power and belief. And only you can create that inside of yourself. This is really a bedrock success principle that most people seem to forget. It's not about a testimony about a product either. It's much more deeper and much more profound than just that. Because, for instance, I've been in more than one company, so it's not about a company. It is about my own personal belief that I build inside of me to the point where I don't let anything extinguish it. I don't let darkness get inside of me to the point where I lose my faith. I don't let doubt get inside of me. I don't let fear get inside of me to the point where it destroys my business. That is something I work on daily, and it's very, very important to me to do that. I hope that has been helpful. That's something you should really think hard on. Listen to this video more than once, because I think you'll hear different things as you grow. If you don't take the time to build who you are, your belief, to the point where you make people truly believe in you and in what you're trying to help them with, they won't get anywhere, and neither will you. You have to help them to the point where they're willing to start working on believing in them. Maybe you have to believe in them before they can believe in themselves, because many people start out being damaged, having darkness inside because of things that have happened to them. And so that is what needs to happen before you can build the great big business that you're expecting to build. It won't happen from doing crazy things like trying to convince people or trying to do any kind of gymnastics or funny talk. Nobody cares for that, and they don't believe in that, and that's actually what puts their walls up when you do that. What needs to happen is that you have enough light and belief and power in yourself that you attract others. And that's something that only you can do for yourself. Now, yes, people can believe in them, in you, to help you get to a certain place. But at some point, you have to take over and be that light yourself. Just like you can light someone else's candle from your candle, but it's up to them to keep that candle burning. If they snuff it out, it wasn't your fault. It was theirs. That is the story I wanted to bring to you today. I've learned that through a lot of hard lessons. I know with all my heart that you can have the power to do whatever you choose to do. But just decide now that you'll be the light instead of the darkness. Because the darkness does not snuff out the light. But the light can snuff out the darkness. I hope that helps. Make sure and go to my blog. That's at lindacromar.com. I have a lot more to share with you there. You can find out more about what I'm doing there as well. That's lindacromar.com, spelled with a Y. Check it out, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.